affair between the secretive East Asian state and the landlocked Uganda. Angelo Bizama is a Ugandan writer and analyst, and he joins us now. Welcome to Newsday, Angelo. Just give us the backstory to start with, the cooperation between Uganda and North Korea. What has that been like, generally speaking?
Well, this cooperation dates back decades, and it was inherited by the government of President Yoweri Museveni, which I think is in its 31st year in power. And it basically comprises two pillars. One is that Uganda supports North Korea's right to use the nuclear weapons in its own defense. Secondly, that the Ugandan government, as we have seen from its voting record in the United Nations, also provides North Korea with diplomatic support by voting no to any country-specific resolution in the United Nations that targets North Korea. In return, the North Koreans generally provide some training to the military and the police, and also some military hardware.
Right, and now two things are emerging from the Park Geun-hye visit to Kampala. Number one, it seems like Uganda is obviously trying to develop a better relationship with the South as opposed to North Korea. But also, it seems like Uganda doesn't want to make so much noise about the nature of its current relationship with North Korea. Am I reading it right?
Yeah, I would be surprised if Uganda abandoned its principles with regard to North Korea. You see, the foreign policy of Uganda is really extracted from the Cold War era playbook. The country is run by pragmatic socialists, and to them, the global reality reflects a clear struggle between the industrialized imperialist oligarch, if you'd like, the interrupted independence of a marginalized pre-modern South. These are major ideological grounds. So what's really happened here is that the Ugandans have stated in a very narrow sense that they are complying with UN Resolution 2217,